Hello, I'm Andrew Watson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. So today I'm going to talk about what you can do both physically and mentally to move yourself from beginner up to intermediate and eventually up to an advanced level of playing guitar. Because, you know, the truth is all of us can get so wrapped up in our ability to have good speed and note control and timing that, you know, we can forget how important it is just to be simply well connected with the instrument by way of our own confidence. And today, I'm going to help you get a lot more confident. So in the second half of this lesson on Patreon, I'm going to give you two extra guitar riffs of simple yet impressive blended chord and melody phrases that are sure to impress anyone who's listening to you play, even if you are a total beginner. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection eBook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the CreativeGuitarStudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson eBook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to CreativeGuitarStudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. There are three important areas to focus on if you want to stop sounding like a beginner, and they're going to be note confidence, being connected to the instrument so you feel comfortable, and the third one is having control over rhythm. So we're going to focus on each one of these individually, the first one being note confidence. Now, what that means is when you play, you want to be really well attuned to what's going on for your hand grip, for where the pick is at when you make your strum against the string, the angle of the pick, the way the grip is between your thumb, let's say, and your first finger, or if you're playing finger style, you want your hand set up in a comfortable way that it's like focused in confidently into the strings you need. And to be able to achieve that, you're going to probably have to work on isolated phrases. It's pretty much the only way to do it. So if you take any short phrase and play it till it's completely memorized, then have your subconscious take over for the phrase and have your conscious mind focused entirely on making the phrase sound confident and solid in its sound, that is going to really start doing it for you. Now, what I've done for an example of this is I've taken a D major chord and then I'm going to hit an open A string and then I'm going to play a short melodic line after that, and at the end we're going to hit this 7th fret D note and we're going to vibrato that, give it a little bit of time to sing, and you put it all together and the phrase entirely will be like this. And what we're going for is a really solid, confident sound, so everything's crystal clear. And the focus too, at the end note where you have a little bit of vibrato, really try to have that subtle, like don't Angus Young the thing, you know, just have it very subtle where it's kind of like a real sweet sound and it's, you know, well balanced against what's going on with the phrase. And that kind of work, you know, that will really focus a lot on the phrase of the idea of the sound, how everything's crystal clear, and it'll build a confidence in you so that as you move on to new phrases, new ideas, new chords that you play, that there'll be a lot of connectedness when you play to exactly what you need, both technically and, you know, I really got to say from a psychological standpoint, so that you're doing things that are really locked in and 100% accurate and they feel really well versed, well connected in what you're doing. Now, speaking of connectedness, that is going to be our next idea. So what you want to do in this respect is think in terms of, again, commit whatever it is you're going to work on to memory. And then what you need to do is play the phrase without looking at your fingers, maybe even better, play the phrase with your eyes shut or distracted. You know, you look out the window at some, you know, traffic going by or whatever. Even another great one that I picked up from a good friend of mine when I was growing up. He said, you know what I often do is I play a song and practice a tune while the radio is playing a totally different song. So, you know, tune into a radio station, maybe even a radio station that you don't really care for, have some tune playing on it, and then play something else while that's going on. It helps you a lot to become very connected with what you're doing on the instrument. Now, I've got a phrase here I want to go over here with you, because it's kind of like staying in key and moving down the neck, and it's creating some triad movement that is arpeggiated. It sounds like this. So this phrase is just taking some triad chords starting in 12th position. And you notice how those slides that are happening there, they're real quick the way I'm making them. I really want to break it into the next position as quickly as I can. And it's a triplet based idea. So it's one, two, three, one, two, three. Have that as a primary goal in your mind, to keep that phrasing together so that everything is well connected and, you know, really locked up well. And once you have it down and it's well memorized, start trying to distract yourself. Whether it, in the beginning, it's just maybe pick a picture on the wall or something to stare at and then try to play. And then maybe do it with your eyes shut. And then maybe you can move on to looking out the window. And then you could turn on the radio to some music going on that has nothing to do with this, and try to keep staying super connected to what you're doing without getting any distractions, you know, coming your way on it. So it's really important to have this, because the connectedness, it's kind of like one of the foundation ideas for overall confidence when you play. And if there's one thing that people notice very quickly, you know, whether it's in a live setting, maybe it's just some friends are over and you grab a guitar and start playing something, if you're confident when you're going through information on the instrument, it really is something that people notice, especially people who don't play an instrument at all. They're just kind of blown away by somebody that can grab a guitar, let's say, and just jam out something. It's really important. And even if it's something simple, like these phrases I'm showing you right now, they're very, very simplistic. And speaking of simplistic, I've got a very basic strum pattern idea that I'm going to be going over with you here next. And what it's going to do is take some triads along the top three strings now. That's a F moving up to a G, and then we're going to do a little C triad. It's not really important what the names are of these, because the big factor here is going to be all about timing and control. And if you're a Patreon member, you're going to get the handout for this. You'll see everything in the handout, and you'll be able to understand how it's all set up. I've got some basic tab coming up on the screen to help you guys out that are just watching on YouTube right now. But if you want more thorough, you know, breakdown of all this, check out the Patreon for it. But what I want to do here with you is, I've got a jam that I'm going to be doing. This is a lot of focus on the strum hand here that we're going to be going over. And for the strum hand action, we're going to be doing very steady down and up strumming, like alternate strumming. So these are going to be all set up as 16th note triplets. So it's going to be that group of six. You can probably hear that. I'm going to slow it down if you can't. One, two, three, four, five, six, just like that. And you want a steadiness, you want the right grip of the pick in between your fingers, especially if you're new to holding a guitar pick. You want to find that perfect grip so the pick flows over the guitar strings very comfortably. Just makes it all that much better for the rhythm guitar aspect. All right, so here's the exercise itself, though. I just kind of, you know, have been fooling around, but the exercise goes like this. One more time. So I'm coming up to F to the G, and then I've got the C chord at the end, you know, basically like a 4-5-1 idea. And in the key of C major, you know, the idea would be that we're just trying to flow through these chords, hit that resolution, lock everything down, and have it happen very smoothly, very controlled. And this helps immensely when you're trying to develop a sense inside yourself of maintaining good groove on parts. It's the hallmark of the best rhythm guitar players in the world. It's really what the pros are doing. They have a fantastic ability for developing perfect timing and control. And to be able to do it, you know, it's one thing to just build the chords and get the technique for the left and right hand abilities and all that. But the other side of the coin on this is you got to have some kind of external device. And whether that's a metronome, or maybe it's a drum machine, or just a drum loop on a sequencer, you need something external to help build your own internal sense of rhythm. Once your body is able to fully understand where it needs to be all the time, to have perfect rhythm. It makes all the difference in the world. The first stage of all this, though, is, of course, you know, for each of these exercises, I know I broke things down into a three-parter here, but for each of these exercises, remember, you want confidence, you want the connectedness to what you're playing, and you want that timing and control, whether you got to use a metronome to get that, or a drum machine, or maybe a loop on a sequencer, whatever it is, you need all three of these, and that is going to be what's going to move you away from being a, you know, just, you know, sounding like a beginner, to start giving you that level of playing where people really kind of look twice at you and go, you know, man, you've really improved on guitar. You sound really good these days. Because if you have the ability for each of these and they're well ingrained and you've done some of the work that I've talked about here, you'll be well on your way to that next level of guitar playing, which is that intermediate level. You want to start branching out through all kinds of different styles at that point and try a lot of different ideas. Maybe I'll have to do another lesson in the future on, you know, stop being a beginner and start being an intermediate player. But, you know, there's a lot of that information over on my website. You can check that out by just heading down to creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got a beginner's course, intermediate course, advanced course over there. We've got lots of electives, so you could check out acoustic guitar, guitar technique, guitar soloing, ear training, music reading. There's a ton of stuff on the site. And there's also a lot of free lessons. If you just open a free account, you got lots of downloads you can do for free stuff over there at all. So it's really accessible. You can hit all that information by going to creativeguitarstudio.com. And for the second half of this lesson, that's going to be available over on Patreon. So you just go to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And we're going to pick up on the second half of this lesson right here. Now, what I'm going to do for you coming up next is going to be a lot of fun, because I'm going to show you some basic exercises that I used, you know, at least variations of them, to move my playing from being real rookie level, you know, real, you know, beginner level, up through, you know, higher levels of playing, and at the same time have fun stuff that is available to play, so that if, you know, everybody that, you know, asks you that question, hey, play me something on guitar, because you're a guitar player, right? You'll feel comfortable doing that, because you'll have something at least that you can show them. So anyway, guys, thanks a lot for joining me here. I look forward to hooking up with you next over on Patreon. Once again, it is patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video for the second half of this lesson. And in the bonus part two video, I'll give you a couple of examples of simple yet impressive blended chord and melody guitar phrases that are sure to impress anyone who's going to listen to you play them. Now, these are some of the same style of ideas that I was given by my first ever guitar teacher so that I could impress my friends and family. And you know what? These are going to help you too, even if you're a total beginner right now. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get jam tracks, and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon, become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members' discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.